Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martije Cazzo for the headlines. Weather forecast. Easterlies affecting Mindanao. Local news. PHIC Davao boasts breast cancer benefits to 1.4 million. Cargo vessel refloated after Davao grounding. DENR Subsergeant notes Philippine trugon, two species of squirrel on Mount Apo. LTFRB Davao, 86%, PUJs, 93% of vans already formed into cooperatives. National news. Maricel Soriano says condo unit is leak, Pidea docks sold in 2012. Philippine inflation for April 2024 stands at 3.8%. International news. Israel takes Rafah crossing as truce talks continue. Putin renews oath for fifth terms with Russia under firm control. Entertainment news. Nintendo Switch 2. Official announcement promise within next year. Marian Rivera, Ding Dong Dantes, Alden Richard, most or more GMA stars received nominations at 72nd FAMAS Awards. For the sports, naibawi namin kayo mga ate. UST dedicates their win to the season 85 seniors. Underperforming man, UTD, one of worst coaches or worst coach team in league. For the features, an epic 38-mile hike to England, northernmost point. Phil Aussie, entrepreneur among finalists for 2024 Women Changing in the World Award. Side stories and the trivia. Do you know that Davao City is home to some of the most beautiful waterfall in the Philippines? Weather forecast. Mindanao will be partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain shower or thunderstorms due to easterlies, localized thunderstorms. Light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news. PhilHealth Davao has increased its benefits package for breast cancer patients significantly from 10,000 from 100,000 to 1.4 million. Dr. Gianile Christine Recocaldo, a medical evaluator of PhilHealth Benefits Administration Section, bared this during the Kapihan sa Davao event on Monday morning, May 6, 2024 at SM City, Davao. Rimocaldo highlighted the necessity for PhilHealth to provide robust financing coverage to its members, particularly given the rising number of cancer patients nationwide. She said that the Z Benefits package for breast cancer patients has been increased to 1.4 million from the previous 100,000. The agency has already disbursed approximately 2.7 million in claims for Z Benefits, primarily under the previous 10,000 or 100,000 coverage. The Coast Guard District, Southeastern Mindanao, CGD-SEM, announced on Monday morning, May 6, 2024, that the cargo vessel that ran aground in Davao Oriental has been successfully refloated. According to CGD-SEM's Facebook post, MGGY Bellatrix, which grounded on May 3, 2024 at Barangay Lavigan, Governor Generoso, Davao Oriental, was refloated successfully at 3:58 a.m. on Monday, May 6, due to favorable conditions. The vessel was fed without external assistance, as reported by the Coast Guard Stations Davao Oriental and Marine Environmental Protection Unit, Southeastern Mindanao, MEPO, SEB. The Department of Environment and Natural Resources, DENR, SOC Sergeant, documented 4 Philippine trugons and 2 species of squirrels known as the Philippine pygmy squirrel and Mindanao tree squirrel on Mount Apo. In a press release, 2 species of squirrels were documented in Mount Apo Natural Park, MANP, through the MANP Cotabato. The former was first documented during the Biodiversity Monitoring System, BMS, activity in 2023, while the latter was noted during the BMS activity from April 22 to 27, 2024. Meanwhile, 4 individuals of the Philippine trugons, Harpactis ardens, a bird species associated with the mythical Ibong Adarna, were documented within the confines of the MANP during the recent BMS activity. An official from the Land Transportation from Chaising and Regulatory Board Region or Davao Region, LTFRB Davao, said that since April 30, the deadline for consolidating public utility vehicles, PUV, around 630,000 public utility jeepney, PUGs, units in the region have joined cooperatives. Noni Tulianos, Regional Director of LTFRB Davao, said in a radio interview on Davao City Disaster Radio, DCDR, on May 3, 2024, that the number of PUGs in the regions that have consolidated reached 6,029 or 86% out of the 733,000 PUJs. In contrast, out of the 592 units, 549 vans have already consolidated or 93%. Lianos added that LTFRB would revoke the franchise of non-compliant PUBs following the central office mandate. However, the non-compliant POJ's drivers would be given a 15-day leeway and advised to follow the government's directives for the modernization project. National news. Veteran actress Maricel Soriano admitted on Tuesday, May 7, 2024, that the condominium unit in Makati City that was indicated in the controversial document that allegedly leaked from the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, PDEA, used to be hers. Soriano made a confirmation during her appearance at the resumption of the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drug Inquiry into the alleged leak of confidential information from PDEA. The investigation stemmed from the alleged leak of an authority to operate and a pre-operation report, both dated March 11, 2012, allegedly used by PDEA about a group of showbiz and politically affluent personalities frequently using illegal drugs inside a condominium in Makati City. The country's headline inflation for April 24, 2024 has slightly gone up to 3.8%. The Philippine Statistics Authority, PSA, said Tuesday, May 7, 2024. The April 2024 inflation is 0.1% higher than the 3.7% in March 2024, but far lower than the one recorded on April 2023, which was at 6.6%. It is the fastest inflation over the past 4 months following the 3.9% inflation in December 2023. The country's inflation rate in January stood at 2.8% and 3.4% in February. Last month's inflation brought the year-on-year national average inflation from January to April 2024 to 3.4% within the government's target range of the 2% to 4%. International news. The Israeli military says its troops have taken operational control of the Palestinian side of the Rafah border crossing between Gaza and Egypt. Rafah has been a key entry point for aid and the only exit for people able to flee since the start of the war between Israel and Hamas in October. A tank brigade moved into the crossing area after a night of intense strike. The United Nations warned that the closure of Rafah meant that the two main aid arteries for Gaza were currently choked off. On Monday, the Israeli military ordered tens of thousands of civilians to begin evacuating nearby eastern part of Rafah City ahead of what it called a limited operation. He could probably have walked in blindfolded. For the fifth time, Vladimir Putin took the long walk through the Grand Kremlin Palace to the Street Andrew's Throne Hall. There he took the oath of office and was sworn in as Russia's president for a new six-year term. "We are a united and great people. Together we will overcome all obstacles. We will bring all our plans to fruition, and together we will win," President Putin told an audience of ministers and dignitaries. The red carpet route may have been familiar to him, but much has changed since President Putin's first inauguration ceremony in May 2000. Back then, President Putin pledged to preserve and develop democracy and to take care of Russia. Entertainment news. Nintendo has finally broken its silence on the successor to its smash hit Switch, but don't get too excited. Fans have been eagerly awaiting news on the console for months, but little official information has emerged. Nintendo President Shuntaro Furukawa has now promised an announcement at some point before March 2025. But he also said there will be no mention of the new machine at the company's Nintendo Direct event next month. In a post on X, The boss of the Japanese company said, "It will have been over 9 years since we announced the existence of Nintendo Switch back in March 2015. The annual Filipino Academy Movie Arts and Sciences, FAMAS, has unveiled the nominees for the year's awards, and several Kapuso stars took part in the list. Kapuso primetime queen Marian Rivera is nominated for Best Actress for the blockbuster film Rewind, which is also up for the Best Picture at the 72nd FAMAS Awards. Kapuso primetime king Ding Dong Dantes, multimedia star Alden Richard, and Sparkle star Ken Chan are vying for Best Actor for their roles on Rewind, Family of Two, and Papa Mascot, respectively. Papa Mascot is also nominated for the Best Picture. Meanwhile, Sparkle actor Ewan Michael Alita is looking to bring home the Best Child Actor Awards for his performance in Firefly, which was produced by the GMA Pictures and GMA Public Affairs. Firefly, which was hailed as Best Picture at the 2023 Metro Manila Film Festival, also received several nominations. And for the sports, following their successful UAAP Season 86 Final Four revenge against the DLSU Lady Spikers, the UST Golden Tigresses dedicated their victory to their senior of seasons 85. It was season 85 when the UST Golden Tigresses, led by the iconic Capitana Iya Laure, pulled off the remarkable performance in the history of collegiate volleyball after handling the undefeated DLSU Lady Spikers. Their first loss of the season and slayed their hopes of a sweep and the step ladder playoff. The black and gold squad outsmarted the girl from Tough in a nail-beating four-seaters to have their nine-game winning streak. But the championship was not destined for the UST by that time in the season 85. Just when you think things can't get any worse for Manchester United, they do. Crystal Palace 4-0 demolition of United on Monday has left Erik ten Hag's men in real danger of missing out of European place for next season as unwanted records continue to tumble. The loss leaves then 8 of the Premier League and out of the European places, although a victory against Manchester City in the FA Cup final would guarantee a Europa League spot. And despite having 10 first-team players out injured, Ten Hag was not pulling any punches. "It is clear and it is obvious," he said. "This is underperforming. We didn't act how we want to do it, and it's by far not good enough." For the featured story, the latest stretch of the King Charles III England Coast Path takes hikers along the enchanted Northumberland coast via Imperius Castle, Airy, Mudsplats, and a tidal holy island. The whole of Britain looks like a witch riding on a pig. So Road Paul, the rocks in the kingdom by the sea, his account of a journey around the coast of Britain in 1982. Within the conceit, the Northumberland coast would not be a pig's snout, Pembrokeshire, or witch hat Scotland, but the rather less interesting witch neck, obscure and forgotten about, just as Northumberland is by many visitors to the kingdom or to the United Kingdom. That is a mistake, however. England's northernmost country has one of the most enchanting stretches of the English coastline, a land of imperious castles, eerie mudflats, and vanishing tidal islands. And it's now easier than ever to explore it on foot, thanks to the opening of the latest stretch and the King Charles III England Coast Path in August 2023. A Filipino-Australian entrepreneur is one of the finalists in this year's Women's Changing the World Awards, a recognition awarded by Duchess of York Sarah Ferguson. Yuna Signo, founder of the virtual assistant platform Kaya Services and co-founder of Vision Outsourcing, is nominated under the Woman in Professional Services category. Both of her companies have been providing employment opportunities for Filipino women, as well as helping Australian in the international female entrepreneurs scales their businesses, brought strategic outsourcing. And for the side stories, let's watch this. For the trivia, do you not know that Davao City is home to some of the most beautiful waterfall in the Philippines? From Aliwagwag Falls to Hagimit Falls, nature lovers will be captivated by the cascading waters and lush surroundings. That's all our news for today. Please share, like, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the Pinoy Rub News Channel activities. This is Gilbert Lopez Martiecaso. Good morning.